Theme parks never stand still. That's why we are now go into a news recap for week 13, 2020. Very briefly on my own behalf, I could use some support for the channel at the moment. In the video description you will find a link to a crowdfunding campaign. Have a look and share if you want. But now, on to the news. Amusement parks in danger. The current situation caused by the spreading of the human malware poses a great challenge for some small and large amusement and theme parks. In addition to the Geiselwind Park, the Dutch internationally renowned Efteling has also asked the authorities for help. Many employees continue to be paid even while they are at home, and without the usual daily turnover, this is an enormous burden for the companies. The US-based Six Flags Group could also get into difficulties again as a result of the ongoing pandemic and head for another bankruptcy. The affected companies worldwide are hoping for government aid, which, where necessary and appropriate, I believe must be provided. Behind every amusement and theme park, there is always a company that provides countless people with jobs and income. This should not be forgotten with all the fun we are missing at the moment. Europa Park donates thousands of Lindt Easter bunnies to a hospital. In a Facebook post, the University Hospital of Freiburg thanks Europa Park and the Mack family for what I think is a great idea. Since it is not possible to receive guests at Europa Park over Easter, but there are already thousands of Lindt chocolate bunnies in the park's storage facilities, the decision was made to make a donation to the hospital. As a thank you that our boys and girls are now giving everything in the service of health. A nice gesture, and although not breaking news, I found it worth mentioning. Family Boomerang at Energylandia. When the rails for Vekoma Family Boomerang appeared at Energylandia, you had to wonder a bit. A similar ride has been existing in the park for quite some time. A comparison picture of the park plans for 2014 and 2020 published on their Facebook page makes it clear that the second Vekoma Family Boomerang will be in the Aqualantis area and will flank the new Abyssus roller coaster. So the park is still building completely unpredictable, and I'm curious when we'll get more information about the mine train that is still on site. I may not even be surprised anymore. That was the news recap for week 13, 2020, and next Sunday we will meet again for the summary of the coming week.